I don't know what.
Okay.
Okay, now I have to speak carefully. So, good evening, good morning, good whatever you wish where you are at the moment. Our last talk is over. And in fact, we've had quite a number of good talks during this week, during these 4 days, which we were meeting together. And apart from that, it was just nice to see familiar faces, sometimes to learn some new faces, which is what we actually get from attending conferences, workshops, and hopefully some communication might come up of the discussions which we've had here during this week. So this is already our sixth Wombat. We started 5 years ago as a local gathering of people in Melbourne. Даже I wouldn't even say in Australia. It was practically in Melbourne and in neighborhoods. And we've grown up significantly. I've been told that this year we've had more participants registered from Europe than from Australia. So it's a kind of recognition, and I think it's a good thing. We had talk also from geographical center somewhere in the Middle East. Okay, maybe we will see. Now, when everything is online, it's even difficult to talk about geography. What is online geography? We're just one community, wherever we are physically. We did have talks from Asia, from North America. I'm not sure whether we had someone from South America. We had last week at the meeting of the Australian Mathematical Society. We're running workshops and conferences all the time. I'm already getting lost. This workshop was planned as a face-to-face meeting. We live in strange circumstances now. We can plan one thing, but a completely different thing comes up in the end. And this workshop was supposed to be in Newcastle, in New South Wales. We had a local organizer there, Bjorn Rufer. He spoke at the opening ceremony. We did have a short opening ceremony on Monday. And an interesting thing, while we were working this week online, Bjorn succeeded to leave Australia and to relocate to Europe. Now he is joining us from Germany. So how to measure distances now, and what is the center, what is geography? And he is smiling. It looks like he likes it better in Germany than it was here. You want to say something, John, right?
Just it's a lot colder. So I think the weather is certainly better in Australia. I can attest to that.
Okay. There are some good things in Australia. Apart from sharks, crocodiles, spiders, we have good weather occasionally. So in terms of geography, we are hoping that we will be able to have the next Wombat in a year, next December, already as a face-to-face meeting. Of course, it doesn't exclude participating online. We've learned how to do this, and it actually works very well. It is even easier to see the slides for me, for instance, with my eyesight, when it is online. So if things go well, the next workshop is going to be in Perth, in Western Australia, and representatives of Perth are already waving us here, Scott. So they are responsible now for first fixing the situation with COVID, and second, for conducting this workshop face to face in Perth. For those who don't know the geography, it is in the west of Australia, very west of Australia, and it is even closer to Europe than Melbourne and Sydney. It doesn't mean that it is easier to get there from anywhere, even from Melbourne. I think for us now, this is the most closed state in Australia now. And it is, for us, it is easier to get to Germany than to Perth right now. But hopefully during the coming year, it's going to change. And I like Perth very much. So I'm hoping also to be invited to the next Wombat and to visit this nice place. So in terms of what's happened this week, we've had some talks. We hopefully have learned something. I'm hoping that some new collaborations can come up, and not only with abstract convexity, which is the most obvious example after today's presentation, but in other areas as well. And it's practically over. So let me wish everybody good health, first of all, avoiding this COVID and, or any other infections. Do good research, produce good theorems, and present new interesting talks at the next workshop. And of course, have a great, safe, festive season. Merry Christmas or whatever you like to celebrate. Enjoy the break. This is probably the most enjoyable part, the break from classes, and start the next year with new strengths, new ideas, new publications, new theorems. Does anyone else want to say anything while we're still here? Vera, do you want to add something?
Sorry, yeah, I don't have good equipment, but yeah, just great to see everybody.
I think what you used was quite good equipment. At least it allowed you to say the right good words. Anybody else? Jorn, do you want to invite us to Germany?
Yes, I think one of the next Wombats should definitely be in Germany. Maybe we have to invent a new name, like Deer or something, just to be make it more country appropriate. But yeah, so
don't
if you can't make
Wombat.
It to Perth, and if the restrictions to Western Australia remain to be in place, which wouldn't surprise me at all, then you'd be very welcome to come to Germany, and I'm happy to then finally deliver on that promise to host Wombat at the institution where I actually am. So I hope we can do that someday.
So we are going to export Wombat, right?
Yeah.
Anyone else? Any more animals?
Thank you to all the organizers. It was a wonderful Wombat, as always.
And anything about Perth, Scott?
Sorry?
Anything about Perth, our next destination?
Yeah, there's quokkas.
Yes, yeah, so we talk about quokkas.
Yeah.
Okay, so if no more comments, words, Eva, you are going to say something?
I would like to thank the organizers for their efforts, for excellent job, for so many excellent Wombats. So I think it expressed the opinion of all the participants. So thank you very much.
Thank you for your kind words, Eva. And also thank you for preparing a strong team of researchers for Wombat and many good talks. Keep it this way.
Thank you.
Okay.
And thank you to the organizers of the special session in honor of Ascend. It was really nice. It was a very nice special session. So thank you to Alex and I think Andrew was involved too.
Yeah, it was of course an unfortunate event that we've lost Ascend Donchev in between these two Wombats. He was our stable participants for several years, and at last Bombard, he was a keynote speaker here, and he actually presented his book at the workshop, his ideas about the book. And now the book is going to be published by Springer, and it's going to appear in the beginning of 2022. So let's hope that we are not going to lose anyone else during this time, and better attract more people, especially more young researchers, to this community, Wombat community, let me put it this way. Okay, thank you very much. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, Happy festive season, and come to the next Wombat in a year.
Yeah, thank you. And can I say some things? Because I am a PhD student, and I want to say thank you for the organizers, and thank you everyone, because it is a opportunity for me and for many people to many students can learn many things from many useful tutorial and many useful talk, and we can learn, and we receive many support from you, from everyone, and I just want to say thank you.
Believe it or not, Lynn, but it often works the other way around when professors are learning from students at such meetings. It happens all the time. So keep teaching us as well. Okay. Okay. So thanks again. And now a well-deserved rest.
So we take a picture as the last. Yes, that year.
Do you know how to do this? If you know,
I think Julian have.